when you discipline yourself in spending, Allah becomes happy with you. Look at this. Look at the gift of Allah. An act of worship to spend properly. Did we ever know that? So when you sit and you have 20 rands in your pocket and you're thinking, how best can I spend this? That itself is already earning the pleasure of Allah. Just the question. Amazing. Amazing. And sometimes we don't realize, we just take out the money, go here, go there. But now what happened to the rest? Don't have anything. Well, we need to adjust. What's very important, the problem of the age, many of us want to lead a life far beyond what we can actually afford, only because the neighbors mustn't see that we're poor. It's a fact. So we want to buy the latest Nokia when there's no bread at home. Allahu Akbar. It's a fact. And we want to ring up bills of so much with recharge cards and what have you, when you know that you need to pay the water bill and the light bill. Well, if that's the case, do away with your phone for the pleasure of Allah. Remember, when you become a good worshipper of Allah, He guarantees you, you will have a good life first. فَلَنُحْيَيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. The first step, He will make you content in life. Content meaning, you might not have everything, but the condition of your heart is such that you're always happy. May Allah make us content. Three things mentioned in this part of the verse. Allah says, those who do not associate any form of partnership with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they never ever call out to anyone besides Allah. لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر. They do not call out to anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their needs. No act of worship to be rendered for anyone or anything besides your maker. Don't take that risk of rendering an act of worship for anything else. Don't even go there. The Christians did it, they have failed. The Jews did it, they have failed. The others did it, they have failed. The traditionalists did it, they have failed. What makes Islam the fastest growing religion today? What is appealing to the intellectual mind of the females who are accepting Islam in their thousands on a daily basis? The intellectuals, is the fact that you have a direct plug-in with your maker. Go and read the articles. Why I accepted Islam. Just Google that and see, one after the other, they say this direct plug-in is unique. You talk to your creator, you confess your sin to nobody besides your maker. No one needs to know what you did, never. And the minute you say, oh Allah, I regret, I admit, I seek your forgiveness, I won't do it again. Those four conditions, your sin is wiped out, deleted, gone, completely forgotten. That's the gift of Allah. This is Islam. To surrender. To whom? To the one who made you alone. This is what Islam is all about. And this is why shaitan comes to us and makes us feel, I need to worship this Mawlana and this Shaykh. We are simply scholars and students of Islam. Our duty is to relay the message. There is nothing grand about this man standing in front of you. I am exactly like you, and so are all the other mashayikh and so on. Yes, we respect them because of the knowledge they have. But at the same time, we never render a single act of worship. There is a fine line between respect and worship, which a lot of people end up crossing without realizing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. Wallahi, the core message of every Nabi, he says, watch out, be careful, never render an act of worship for anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us all search in our lives. Let's never worship money, never worship items, never worship people, never worship objects, nothing at all. We worship Allah alone. لِلَّهِ الْأَمْرُ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَمِنْ بَعْدُ. For him is the command from the beginning, before everything, and at the end, after everything. Solely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.